All right, I got a video up that I made a long time ago, kind of spur of the moment, and it's about how to change your oil. So I'm gonna try to make a better one, even though that gets a lot of views and this probably won't get any, at least I'll have one up that I can point to that's better than that one. Basically what you need is some kind of catch can, you know, 10W30 synthetic, and a funnel, and a 10 millimeter for this bike, or whatever your bike takes for the drain bolt. So first of all, warm your bike up. I rode mine a while ago, it's still hot, still warm. It is. Yeah, that was on there way too tight. So I got this bike jacked up. You don't really need to do that, but you know, you do want to have it so you can see. I have it tilted a little bit downhill so it drains a little better. And there's also a washer. I don't know if you can see that. There's a washer there. You don't want to lose that in there. Or if you're doing this outside, you don't want to lose that in the grass. So I just like to pull this out, keep tension. Oh, there you go. Got a little oil on me. Yeah, this thing's really too big. I wish it was a little smaller, but well, I guess I can't even lose it with this screen. That's nice. So I ran this about, I don't know, I think on the clock I have about 6/10 of an hour. Okay, you can loosen this up. Loosen your fill plug. All right, so it's still dripping out of there. And I'm gonna drop this down and put it on the ground and get the engine level and fill it, but I'll probably just take it off of the stand. It's just easier to film on the stand, basically. Then you just snug it up. Yeah, these are really nice to have, but you can just get like an old laundry detergent bottle. That's one of the big ones and you can just cut a hole in it. Yeah, I think I still have one up there. This is one I had up there. It's really cool because it don't, actually I might start using this again because that it's smaller and it might even work better. And then, you know, you can get a bunch of oil in there and you just pour it out. Put some rags in there and then they'll soak up the oil and then you throw them away. And it's actually probably better than that in some circumstances. So you can get the bike more upright with a 2x4 or something like that. Make sure it's not too far upright, but just more upright than laying over on a kickstand. I could definitely get a better funnel for this. Well, for this bike, it seems like it might work better, but my other ones, I kind of have to hold it because it wants to fall out of there, but this seems like it might work. Some chunk around there. I want to clean this off. Just make sure there's no dirt on this thing. Now I'm just going to use, I just have this stuff laying around. I think I bought it for my car or something, but I have enough in there and it's just 5W30 synthetic. But you know, 10W30 is usually what you should put in here. Full synthetic after your first break-in because these have no oil filter. And it takes about, I guess, 0.6 quarts or something like that. But I just fill it up to, you know, about here. I mean, most mini bikes will come with a manual. It tells you how much to put in there. Most, all engines do in general. I got this much in here, so I'm probably gonna be going down to about there with it. See, and about here, and it was up to here, so I probably got about down to there to go. But you can look, just look in there. So I'm getting close. Let's see what it looks like. Yeah, see, it's right up there. You can see when I wiggle it, it's right up there. So that's perfect. It's right about up to there, and that's fine. You just do this hand tight. Try to get your fingers in there. could snug it up like an eighth of a turn with pliers. It's not going to hurt anything. And then just make sure there's no spots of oil. That's, I mean, you don't really have to do this, but I like to just clean it up a little bit, because dirt will just get attracted to it if you don't do this. And by running 5W30, what all that means is I can run this in a little bit colder weather. But that's the winter. The W is the winter. And there's a scale. There's a chart that you can follow. But most people, 10W30, 10W40. If you get 5W30, it's fine. It'll run just fine. Okay, let's just start it up, make sure it works. You just want to check for leaks. I don't see any leaks. That's how easy it is to change your oil. You should do it all the time, pretty much. Yeah, so if you want your engine to last, change your oil all the time. People ask me how often. I don't know. I think it depends on how hard you ride the thing, how often you ride it. There's a guide usually on the manual will tell you how many hours, but you just kind of get a feel for it after a while. You just change it when you feel like you should. It's probably fine. Oil's cheap. So are these engines, but oil's cheap. So just change it often and should run good for a long time. All right. Ride safe. Later.